A patient presents with stabbing, electric shock-like pain on the right side of her face. The workup and treatment today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel, everything oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton, and today we're going to be talking about a patient who presented with severe right facial pain of unknown origin. This patient is a 64-year-old female who recently began to experience severe debilitating pain. She localizes the pain to her right cheek, nose, upper teeth, and upper lip. She has low-grade pain while awake, but several times a day she also experiences a stabbing pain that lasts a few seconds. She sometimes experiences the stabbing pain while brushing her teeth, but even a light touch can elicit the pain. She has no history of these stabbing pains, but she does report low-grade chronic pain for years. In fact, all of her upper right posterior teeth have root canals, none of which helped her discomfort. Let's run the list. We have a 64-year-old female with recent onset sharp stabbing pain in the midface that's provoked by a stimulus in the area. At the top of my list is trigeminal neuralgia. I see a lot of patients with facial pain who've been told they have trigeminal neuralgia. It's almost treated as a catch-all term for facial pain, but trigeminal neuralgia has specific clinical symptoms and diagnostic criteria. Trigeminal neuralgia presents as recurring episodes of brief, one-sided, electric shock-like pains that are abrupt in onset and termination. The distribution is along one or more of the fifth cranial nerve branches, also known as the trigeminal nerve. The pain is typically triggered by a stimulus. It starts and ends quickly, usually only lasting a few seconds. Facial muscle spasms can be seen with severe pain attacks, which is where the old name for this disorder comes from, tic douloureux. Trigeminal neuralgia is usually unilateral or one-sided. The majority of patients experience pain in the midface, the V2 branch, or the lower face, the V3 branch. Less than 5% of cases are isolated to the upper face, the V1 branch. Trigeminal neuralgia is classified by the underlying cause. The categories are classic, secondary, and idiopathic. Classic is 75% of cases and is due to a neurovascular compression with morphological changes in the trigeminal nerve root. Secondary is 15% of cases and is caused by an underlying disorder such as multiple sclerosis, a tumor, or an arteriovenous malformation. The third category is idiopathic and shows no abnormalities on imaging, which is 10% of cases. This patient's symptoms, history, and exam all point to trigeminal neuralgia. Up to 50% of patients with this disease have chronic low-grade persistent pain between their stabbing pain. Patients can have this low-grade chronic pain years before trigeminal neuralgia develops. Unfortunately, this can lead patients to have dental work that does not help with their discomfort. MRI and MRA are the imaging studies of choice to evaluate the trigeminal nerve and surrounding areas. I ordered these studies, which did confirm morphologic changes in the nerve where it leaves the pons. Unfortunately, there is no cure for trigeminal neuralgia, but there are effective treatment options. First-line medications include carbamazepine and oxcarbazepine. Gabapentin, lamotrigine, clonazepam, and baclofen are other pharmaceutical options. If patients don't respond to pharmacotherapy, or if they're unable to tolerate medication side effects, there are surgical options. A surgeon may suggest microvascular decompression, where the vessel touching the nerve root is repositioned or removed. Other options include severing the nerve at the root using various techniques, or gamma therapy, where radiation is used to target the nerve root. This patient was placed on carbamazepine and had significant improvement. Trigeminal neuralgia waxes and wanes in severity, and recurrence is common. She will require a regular follow-up at her neurologist and still may need surgery eventually. Thanks so much for watching today's episode. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out the channel for all kinds of interesting content on oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.